మధ్యాహ్నం చంద్రబాబు బృందం రాష్ట్రపతిని కలిసింది. అనంతరం చంద్రబాబు మీడియాతో మాట్లాడుతూ విభజన హామీలు, ప్రత్యేక హోదాపై రాష్ట్రపతికి వినతిపత్రం అందజేశామన్నారు. విభజన హామీలు అమలు చేస్తామని ఎన్నికల సమయంలో నరేంద్ర మోదీ చెప్పిన విషయాన్ని ఈ సందర్భంగా గుర్తుకు చేశారు. విభజన హామీలను కేంద్రం విస్మరించిందని ఆయన విమర్శించారు. ఏపీ ప్రజల న్యాయమైన డిమాండ్లను అమలు చేయాలని డిమాండ్ చేశారు. ఏపీకి నిధులు విడుదల చేయకుండా కేంద్రం కాలక్షేపం చేసిందని ఆయన మండిపడ్డారు. హైదరాబాద్ అభివృద్ధికి 60 ఏళ్ల పాటు కృషి చేశామని, హైదరాబాద్ను ప్రపంచ స్థాయి నగరంగా తీర్చిదిద్దామని చంద్రబాబు చెప్పారు. ప్రధాని మోదీలో నాయకత్వ లక్షణాలు లేవని బాబు విమర్శించారు. దేశాన్ని అభివృద్ధి చేయాలన్న ఆలోచన మోదీకి ఏ కోసానా లేదన్నారు. రాష్ట్రంలో 17 జిల్లాలలో ధర్మ పోరాట దీక్షలు చేశామని, ఢిల్లీ దీక్షతో ఏపీ ప్రజల బాధను దేశం మొత్తం తెలియజేశామన్నారు. ఏపీకి విభజన హామీలు, ప్రత్యేక హోదా కోసం పార్లమెంటులో నిరంతర పోరాటం చేస్తున్నామని చంద్రబాబు తెలిపారు.
That's why political parties supported us in Rajya Sabha. Further, they demanded special status for 10 years. The then Prime Minister has announced 5 years as special status. On the basis of that, the bifurcation is done. But people of Andhra Pradesh never satisfied with all these things. Very unfortunate for Andhra Pradesh. Since independence, we have seen 4 capitals. Before, after independence, we were in Madras presidency. Then with the sacrifice of Potti Sriramulu, separate state has come. We moved to Karnool. We worked 3 years in tents, sheds. From there, all people, Telugu people from Hyderabad state, Andhra Pradesh state, they want to unite. That is the first state. Linguistic state for Telugu community. 60 years we worked there with hard work, with innovative way, we invested everything. I was responsible creating Hyderabad world class city, one of the best economic city, best ecosystem. If you see outer ring road, airport, under Cyberabad city, everything I conceived at the time for Telugu community. Ultimately, again, division has taken place. There is no level playing field. I am using this word. Whenever there is a division of a family or a company or a state or a country, there will be a level playing field, equal distribution of assets and liabilities and opportunities. That has missed totally. Then the present government, Narendra Modi, before that, he told very clearly, they have killed, they wanted to protect child, they have killed the mother also. Now, we are asking him what you have done. During elections, he promised all these things, letter and spirit. He said he will implement everything. During the foundation laying ceremony of Amaravati, he brought Yamuna water and also our parliament matti. Both he has given on our face. That is how he misbehaved. Then onwards, he never bothered about Andhra Pradesh. He never cared about the sentiments of Andhra Pradesh. People are very annoyed. 125 years history of Congress party, when bifurcation take place in spite of special status given and also bifurcation act provisions, they voted against Congress party. Now BJP is playing with our lives and the fate of our future generation. They are affecting the sentiments of Andhra Pradesh. All these things we explained to President of India. We asked him, being the constitution head, he has to direct the government for executing the bill enacted in the parliament and also the promise given by the then Prime Minister on the floor of the house in the Rajya Sabha. On the basis of that only, bill was passed in the Rajya Sabha at that time. All these things we reminded him. Today, we came as a protest rally. All political parties, employee associations, Praja Sangalu, all of us, as we had a protest rally, supported all leaders, and finally 11 member team, we went to president. We represented all these issues to the president. He, the constitutional head, is having responsibility to safeguard the interest of everybody. When government is ignoring, this government is doing divide and rule. Now it is the responsibility of president to unite the country. Narendra Modi don't have any right to unveil the statue of Sardar Patel also. He wanted to unite the country, whereas Narendra Modi wanted to have only one man show. Even there, he only his photo, not even the chief minister. Everywhere he is creating problems. Among states, he is creating rift. Among communities, he is creating rift. Among people, he is bringing hatred campaign. He is very unfortunate. Even on political party leaders, he is victimizing. He is doing great harm to this country. Whenever you are asking genuine demand, then he is using intelligence, CBI, ED, all government agencies to kill the leadership. Either it is bureaucracy, either it is media, it is political parties, corporate, he is killing leadership. Leadership will build over a period of time. Sometimes leaders will born as leaders, from there they will build their characters. Today, you don't have any right to kill leadership in India. It will be any leadership for that matter. You don't have leadership qualities. You didn't have proper education also. You don't have any development agenda also. At the same time, we are having our own track record. We have done so many things for the nation building. You don't have any right to humiliate us or insult us or affect our sentiments. It is a sentimental issue. It is a right. Because what I am saying, 60 years we struggled. After that, state has been divided without giving anything. Even what they have promised, you are not giving. What is in the act, you are not executing. What is the right you are having? It is 5 crore people's sentiment. They are all totally annoyed. Even now, and Prime Minister should realize this. At least you don't have any sentiment because you don't have anybody. But people are having sentiment that he has to understand. That is where we are demanding. We are confident. President has to do something, or otherwise, through court, we will fight and we will go to people's court finally, and we will get verdict. On the basis of that, we will get all our demands to be achieved. Today, I am very sad. I told you, yesterday I announced one of our worker, not our worker. He didn't come with us. He came on his own. He is physically handicapped. Separate train, he came here. On this event, he was totally disturbed, mentally disturbed. He thought nothing is happening. So with his sacrifice, at least Delhi rulers may move forward. That is his aspiration. Because of that, he sacrificed his life in Delhi. He has chosen Delhi as a venue for his sacrifice. This is what everybody in Delhi has to understand. You must know the value of life. If you won't know the value of life, country will have so many problems in future. So I want this government, you cannot do as you like. We are also part and parcel of this country, great country. So what are all due for us, without any hesitation, you have to fulfill. That is our demand, that is our ultimatum for this government. No, me andariki telusu. President is a constitutional head. Under the same time, we will represent ultimately, that is the final authority, political authority, our constitutional head, we have to represent. We have represented to him also. I think wisdom has to prevail on President Rashtrapati Bhavan. What is the action they have to take, we have to watch.
Sir, what after this, sir, you have went to the President, and after this, what, sir? Will we moving to court, sir, after this?
No, definitely we will fight on the courts, that is ultimately justice. Now political and constitutional head, up to President we have moved. With all difficulties for the last 4.5 years, different people are here, different associations are here. They agitated differently. Now we are doing collectively, state as a unit. Some political parties, some people may have vested interest, or they are having some links with the present NDA. But overall, we are all one in protecting the interest of our people. Now it is a constitutional head is also over. Now only court, there is one more avenue for us. And ultimately, all political parties are supporting. Then there is an opportunity. We will take people's mandate. Then alternative government will come. That is what everybody assured. First decision, they are going to do these two things.
Sir, మన గతంలో మీరు కోర్టుకి వెళ్ళారు ఉన్నత విద్యా మండలి విషయంలో కోర్టు చెప్పినా కూడా ఇంప్లిమెంట్ చేయలేదు మరోసారి మనం
నో నాట్ ఓన్లీ దట్ కోర్ట్ హస్ సెడ్ వెరీ క్లియర్లీ ఆన్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ 58-42% రేషియో దే హావ్ టు డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ ది అసెట్స్ అండ్ మనీ అవైలబుల్ విత్ దట్ But at the same time, the government of India has given contrary to that order. They said on location basis, all assets will go. Location is Hyderabad. Naturally, they will have all entitlement. It is against the court verdict. So again we are going for court on contempt. That is what we are doing. We will fight it out.
Mr. CM, you are fighting for special status. But BJP is targeting your family members and you. Why? They are targeting you personally. You have any thing between you and Modi?
I am asking you, Modi always hit below the belt. As a matter of fact, I demanded long back when Godhra incident. During that time, I asked Vajpayee, you take action against Gujarat government. He violated Rajdharma, so he had to take action. At that time he tried, but he couldn't do it. So he may have all these things in mind, but I cannot help it.
Sir, Congress party pedalandaru mee ex ga matha telukara ite mee stand ela undabothundi potto yelli avakasam unda Andhra Pradesh lo lekapothe ondragane periga
nenu emantaru Congress party poorthiga sahakarincharu vachina vallu including Rahul Gandhi nunchi first decision memu special status istam పోలవరం డబ్బులు ఇస్తాం అన్నీ చేస్తాను వాళ్ళు చెప్పారు వాళ్ళు చెప్పినప్పటికీ అక్కడ రాష్ట్ర ప్రజల మనోభావాలు చాలా ముఖ్యం అవన్నీ పరిగణలో తీసుకొని మేము నిర్ణయాలు
చేసుకుంటాం
అంటే ధర్మదీక్షతో ఇవన్నీ ప్రాసెస్ ఇవన్నీ ధర్మ పోరాట దీక్ష 11 జిల్లాల్లో పెట్టాం ఇక్కడికి వచ్చి నిన్న కూడా పెట్టి దేశానికంతా చెప్పగలిగాం చేసిన అన్యాయం అంతా పార్లమెంట్లో రాజీ లేని పోరాటం ఇంతవరకు చేశాం వివిధ సంఘాలు కూడా వాళ్ళకు తోచిన విధంగా ఆల్వేస్ ఫైట్ చేస్తూనే వచ్చాయి